So let's start with this Jyeshtha Nakshatra. And we will go with the same approach to the mantra of Jyeshtha, understanding the deity of Jyeshtha, the stories of Jyeshtha, the remedies of Jyeshtha, and the result of different padas in Jyeshtha. Right? Before I go there, there's a small formal announcement that, as you people must be aware of, that this is a part of a course, right? And the course is divided into four sections. The first section dealt with the signification of nakshatras. About Rashi, we know, you know, this is a movable sign, that is a fixed sign. This is an Agni Tattva Rashi, that is a Jala Tattva Rashi. Right? These things are there with Rashis. The same things are there with nakshatras as well. Sometimes the division is a bit different, but it is still there. Right? So in nakshatras, there is this Andha Mandha Kana Sulochan. Right? Then there is the symbology of the nakshatra, how many stars are in the nakshatra, the nakshatra being kula kul, the span of nakshatras, the tightness of the nakshatra, the rigidity of the nakshatra, etc., etc. That we have dealt in the first part of the course that we have done before. Two, three classes are pending that I will do. This is the second part of the course where we are going deeper into the deities and the stories and the mantras of the nakshatra. Then there will be the third section of the course. I am not telling it to be a part because this is all the same part only. Right? So in the third section of the course, we will deal with the how the sages interpreted the nakshatras, how the sages understood the nakshatra. If I have to give you a small example, like if you go to Brihat Jatakam, you'll find that for someone born in Jyeshtha, right, that is our topic today, for Jyeshtha, it is told that the Jyeshtha person will have a very few friends, will be well contented in whatever he have, and he will be virtuous as well, but he will be very angry also. So why this thing is told for Jyeshtha? What is there in Jyeshtha that makes Jyeshtha like this? Right? So this is something that we are going to deal about the second part of the course. And the third part of the course will deal with the most important aspect, that is the karma of the nakshatra. Right? Karma of the nakshatra, as in, you know, like everything in astrology, as we are well aware of, that astrology is a... Sages have mentioned astrology to be a boat which helps people cross the ocean. Astrology is also told as a lamp which helps you look the thing kept in dark. That is your karma that is kept in dark, right? So, like with every Rashi, with every planet, there is a karma that is supposed to be done. And same is the thing with nakshatras as well. Nakshatras have a few pending karmas also. What needs to be done, etc. And glimpse of some karmas you must have got throughout this nakshatra stories as well. And the karmas in depth, in detail, we will learn in the course. Right? And this is the last class that we are streaming, that we are giving on YouTube. Right? From Moola, all the classes will be students only. Right? With this small announcement, let's start with Indra. let's start with Jyeshtha. Jyeshtha is ruled by Indra, and as you may be aware of, that Indra is the king of the gods. So this nakshatra indicates kingship, someone who is a king, who behaves like a king. You know, Jyeshtha means the one who is the eldest one. As the king looks over his fraternity, as the king looks over his kinsmen, the Jyeshtha person have to look over the, like have to, you know, take care of the extended responsibilities of the family or of anything. If there is the seventh lord in Jyeshtha, then extended responsibility of the spouse, family, etc. Have to look over the extended family. In tune with the life story of Indra, Jyeshtha person is also challenged multiple times, and he have to work very hard in order to keep his position intact, keep his authority intact. The person is generally challenged by people, and you know, like almost everyone, his brothers don't respect him, so he have to fight and work to earn that respect. Maybe his parents don't give him much respect, you know, like don't talk well with him, and he have to work to gain their respect, etc. This is the way it goes, because it is ruled by Indra. Vishakha is like quite hardworking, and the symbol of Vishakha is kundal. Kundal is something that you wear in the ear, that generally kings wear in their ears, right? So in tune with that particular thing, Vishakha person, till the time they haven't proven themselves, is a victim of politics, office politics, home politics, whatever, or is a victim of, you know, like is not much respected. But once they realize their potential and start working in the area, they gain respect, and people want to flaunt their association. Jyeshtha have that power of, from being a normal person, to become such an authoritative person whom everyone wants to have a contact with. Generally, when you grow up in power, everyone will want to have a contact with you by some way or the other. So that is the story of Jyeshtha as well. And Jyeshtha indicates the, you know, Indra as a lord will come at multiple places. Right? The aspect of Indra in Jyeshtha is that Indra who have ascended to the highest position, the king of the Devas, right? So he have to look after a lot of things, look after a whole lot of responsibilities, and like Vishakha and Anuradha, this person is also very much interested into philanthropy, charity, helping people, etc. Specifically, you know, empowering the skills of people is something that comes naturally to Jyeshtha, right? Like the elder sister of Lakshmi is not much worshipped, and we clean our house every day just to keep the elder sister of the Lakshmi away from the home, because she is taken as the cause of penury. The same is the story with Jyeshtha. That when this Jyeshtha person is not on the top, when the Jyeshtha person haven't realized himself, at that point of time, people, try to part ways from him. But once he gains prominence, people want to come in contact with him. This is what happens with Jyeshtha. Jyeshtha indicates the conquering power and how people conquer. But this conquering over things, circumstances, Jyeshtha will generally will be born in a situation which is not very favorable. Everything in the starting part of life, everything in the life of a Jyeshtha person will be challenging, be it finances, be it relationships, or be it anything. And this person have to prove himself to come as a winner. That is the theme about Jyeshtha. Right? This person is capable of achieving many things in life. But just like Hanuman, he is not realizing his true potential and worth, which by way of unfortunate incidents in his life, he will come to realize. But that realization is very painful and very problematic. And it will be very difficult for the person to go through it. So, you know, Jyeshtha does indicate the trait that life from starting is very difficult. And over the time, it becomes more and more challenging. But after the age of 38, 39, there is a change in life if the person does hard work. Otherwise, Jyeshtha being a Gandhanath Nakshatra does indicate challenges, obstacles, and hurdles in life. With all the Gandhanath Nakshatra, the theme is that the person born in this Nakshatra is not supposed to survive. If he does, he will be a king, he will be a ruler, he will have influence over many people. Right? But the test is to be given, and the test is the most difficult for Jyeshtha. Like the elder person in the family, he have to sacrifice a whole lot of things for the family. In whichever field it is, right? If there is the seventh lord, then in marriage. If it is the fifth lord, then related to children. If it is the fourth lord in Jyeshtha, then it is related to mother. The person have to sacrifice a lot of things to keep that relationship intact or that particular area of life happy. Right? So Jyeshtha goes with the concept of compromise. If you don't compromise with Jyeshtha, it is very problematic. You know, leaving things as per your choice, leaving things just by your will, leaving things, sacrificing things is the trend and the tone for Vishakha. Sorry, Jyeshtha. I'm remembering Vishakha today. Jyeshtha. Jyeshtha. The effect of Jyeshtha is like grinding, right? In the mantra of Jyeshtha that I am not reading to you today, the mantra of Jyeshtha does indicate the word attacking, crushing, and grinding. So that crushing and grinding is something that happens with this person, right? Clashing of ego, broken self-esteem, or the person going through such a bad experience which causes trauma is a common trait of Jyeshtha. And to come out of that trauma, to come out of that shock, will take a whole lot of time and much efforts on the part of the Jyeshtha person. Along with this, Jyeshtha is very good for killing the enemies. Generally, there is no one who can win over a Jyeshtha person. He is always winner in the end. So in the matter of litigation and fights and crushing their enemies, Jyeshtha people are very fortunate. Right? But Jyeshtha people should be highly cautious. The Jyeshtha people should be highly cautious about not having enmity with anyone. The sense of competition, the sense of enmity, the sense that someone else should lose. Of course, the person will lose, but that thing will cause problem to the jishta person as well. So the sense of competition is something that you should let go of in jishta. Jishta persons are naturally very talented. Jishta indicates talent, specifically talents related to dancing and singing. So if the seventh lord is in jishta, your spouse will be well versed in dancing and singing. If the fifth lord is there in jishta, then your children have to do something with dancing and singing, etc. If the seventh lord is Jupiter and that is in jishta, then the result goes to both the sibling and both the spouse and the child, both this particular way. And jishta is very good for business. That jishta supports business. And jishta people, if they go into business, they do very well, earn very good amount of money. Right? Along with this, jishta also indicates high level of education, scholarly distinction, and someone being well read, well educated, and someone whose educational achievements are very high. That is also indicated by jishta. Along with this, jishta indicates beautiful people. And the policies of jishta is very beautiful, right? Jishta cannot do favorism. Right? Jishta is always neutral, and the policies of a jishta person is very much neutral for everyone. Jishta is not easily pleased, is not pleased by good words, or not pleased by, not pleased by buttering. We have very clear set rules and fundas, rules and formulas, and he abides by the dharma, and he will try to do good with everyone. And, will not take a decision under pressure. Bribe, etc. is what jishta people won't like. If you are born in jishta and if you have taken a bribe, congratulations, you have spoiled your jishta. Getting my point? So these things for jishta, and more about Indra, I have discussed in the Chitra video. I will refer you to go to the Chitra video and take things from there. Okay. Coming to the remedies of jishta. See, three things are there, I will teach you. Thing one. Because jishta is the eldest one, who is eldest in your family? Pitrus. Right? And an afflicted jishta will indicate that you have forgot your pitrus, or you have done something for their displeasure. They are angry against you. Generally, this turns out to be a problem in having progeny, or problem with children, right? So jishta people should always do pitru darpan and give some donation to pitrus, right? So generally, whenever you do any puja, etc., you should organize a special worship for your pitrus, your ancestors, and whichever Brahmin is doing that ancestor worship, you should give them some food, grains, and clothes for your ancestors to them. That is one major remedy for jishta. Right? Second major remedy I will tell you related to coconut. So you should have a coconut in your home. You can take a kalash, right? So you can take an earthen pot, fill it with water, and you put a coconut over it. Tie the coconut using mauli and a cloth and worship that. That is the second remedy for Jyeshtha. People who cannot worship should take a coconut in their hands, should do some prayer for Indra, and should like throw it in water. So, I should say like let it flow with water. Throwing is not a good word. That is not a javelin throw that you have to do. It's like peacefully, carefully. You are giving it to the water god to eat. Kind of a scenario. And thirdly, a Jyeshtha will generally will see a problem that their work chair or their work table will be occupied by other people as well, right? You know, like other people of the family or other people of the company. So generally, Jyeshtha people, like, you know, and this is a normal Vastu tip that I can give you, that the main table which you use to sit, which you use to work on, should only be occupied by you. And no one else should sit over it. Like everyone should respect that it is your chair. So that particular thing you have to be very careful about for Jyeshtha, that no one should occupy your things. Right, you know, like keeping your things untouched by other people, specifically the chair, and specifically other things which are related to authority. That you should not let other people touch it or use it. Okay. Coming to the padas of Jyeshtha. The first pada of Jyeshtha will be Scorpio sign and Sagittarius Navamsha. It does indicate someone who fights for dharma. Someone who fights for others and also like tends to give sacrifice for others. And along with this, the trait that comes with Jyeshtha pada one, the person sacrifices for others, works for the society, and most importantly, gets punished because of others, because of the fault of others. Because he supported someone, he will get punished because of that particular support. Finances are good. Relationship with family members are bad. The person is generally fortunate in the matters of children. The wife is very good, but the natives relationship and behavior with his wife may not be good. Right? The person is charming, attractive, is much worried about his family and about his family members, takes care of his family under any circumstances. Right? And along with this, the person is generally into spirituality and also into yoga. His health is not good, despite the body being robust. There are issues related to weight and digestion. And the person will see many unfortunate events in his life, specifically from the age of 21 to 28. Right. Along with this, the native will be impudent, very intelligent, scholarly, learned, generally proficient in many languages, possesses a deep level knowledge of ancient things such as astrology, grammar, Sanskrit, etc. He will be very powerful, maybe into bodybuilding as well. Law and justice is very suitable for this person. He is completely against taking sides. Right? He will be diplomatic, skillful. will have less hair, will have a tendency to become bald early, will have compact eyebrows, big nose, elongated ears, and the person will be supported by his father, but will be unfortunate. For the Jeshta Pada 1. The Jeshta Pada 2 will be Scorpio sign and Capricorn Navamsha. In the case of Scorpio sign and Capricorn Navamsha, the person have a good body, good health. He will be charming, attractive, pleasing, beautiful, handsome, whatever. Beautiful is used for woman and handsome is used for male actually. So beautiful, handsome, skillful, skillful, famous, respected by people, achieves great heights in profession as well as in society. Generally serves a higher position, right? But he don't have many people to support him. Even the normal things of life like purchasing a car or buying a home will not be very easy for this person. Good things are generally delayed. And he will have to wait unnecessarily for something to happen. Marital life is not good. The spouse is not loving that much as the person is. His love is not easily reciprocated. Right? The time of rest, he will not be able to completely rest, right? Even like, you know, he sleeps after a fight, he wakes up with a fight, right? So there is no particular time in his life where he can have complete peace of mind kind of a scenario, right? And the person generally doesn't want to work despite being offered high position. He will not tend to take it, but will want to go with his will. So despite being offered an IPS position, he will be the one who will want to like open a normal shop because he want to do it for the empowerment of someone. So this is generally a person who will lose multiple opportunities in life just because to do good for others. Along with this, the life because of these traits will be a bit hard. There will be many disappointments in life. Stock market, lottery, etc. is highly strictly prohibited. The person have to uselessly wander from one place to another place. And peace of mind is something that is very difficult to achieve. The face will be like, you know, like it will be... The face will look like, you know, like it is two different parts. The, you know, body parts will not be proportionate. One eye bigger, one eye smaller kind of a case is that tribute that mask generally indicates. So he will have a split face, split type of a face. Right? And he will have a strong body. But his teeth will not be good. Right? So he will have like, you know, uneven teeth. And... He will not have belly, he will not have stomach, he will not have a like prominent stomach, he will have very thin waist, will look beautiful because of that, right? He will have a squint eyes, bhenga kehte hai isko hum log, right? And he will be very splendorous, very hardworking, very industrious, and will be focused on sharing his knowledge and uplifting people. Coming to the next part, the third pada of Jeshta, that is Scorpio Rashi and Aquarius Navamsha. Despite the person's hard work, he will not get things in the amount which he should have, like, you know, for his 100% of hard work, he will only get 50% of the reward. The person is generally wealthy, But the social recognition and fame is a bit difficult, right? The person is have a very strong mind and intellect, and it is generally a person who likes to plan things beforehand before doing it. And it is someone always thinking, always depressed, always thinking, always mentally unstable, and at the same time planning for every tiny thing. Okay. The person tends to get comforts in life. He have all the luxuries. He will only want to associate with people who give him happiness. And even if he is unhappy with his family members, he will try to leave his family members and will try to be with friends, etc., who give him happiness. Easily taken over by good words. Right? This is a person who will achieve vehicle, home, land, properties in life quite easily. The mother will be a very prominent influence in life. Education will not be that much good, but the person will have a very good functional knowledge of things. Enmity will be a big hurdle in life. And generally, enemies will take away his business. The relationship with wife is very good. Life is long, right? But the person is generally unfortunate. He struggles for fame, which comes easily when he stops searching for fame. Till the time he keeps on searching for fame, fame is difficult to get. Finances and riches he can easily have. Right? With his family member, he has to struggle. And many a times, the burden of family will come on this person. Specifically, this is a person who is, you know, like, who wants to do everything very quickly. 80% of the things he will make bad, he will do bad in his life because of his nature of doing things quickly. That patience is something that he doesn't know. And not keeping patience in life will lead him to many troubles and will, you know, make him lose a lot of things. Right? Along with this, the native may have some problem with eyesight and will generally be prone to gain weight after 30-35. And will have problems related to obesity, like, you know, cholesterol issues, breathing issues, etc. And some operation in childhood he must have been through. Along with this, the person's temperament will not be very good. He will be fighting with everyone and will be short-tempered. Right? He will have a very broad nose. And may have met with some small fire accident also. Like, he will be dark in complexion. He will not be a very virtuous person. Generally, in marital matters, you cannot like trust this person. Even if trustworthy, then still he is at least luring or, you know, spying or ogling people of another gender, at least for sure. Right? He will he have to take care of pettiness. Generally, he is not very well organized. It is generally someone who hates bathing, or, you know, his bathing schedule is not very good, not very apt. Right? His hair will be good. He can be easily fooled. But at the same point of time, his determination and his willingness to achieve something will, you know, like make him have many things in life. But only if he focuses on his good qualities. Otherwise, this is a person who is very good at torturing and blackmailing. And other than that, it is like, you know, not good for multiple things. Coming to the last pada of Jyeshtha, that will be Scorpio sign and Pisces Navamsha. The person will be learned, intelligent, will know many languages, will be blessed in the matters of children. Generally tends to lose many things in life. It is a person who will be very unfortunate, will not be able to get things from his parents. Right? He have to struggle on many things. Happiness, luxuries, comforts, vehicles, home, etc. comes in life but comes late. Right? the person is learned, intelligent, have all the good qualities for that matter, right? He is also fortunate in the matter of marriage, generally a love marriage, like a spouse loves them, and spouse is like completely dedicated to this person, right? But both the people, both the, like this person and his spouse, both of them have their own weakness and shortcomings, which they understand. Generally indicates a scenario where the spouse and the native both can freely engage with the people of opposite gender by, like, you know, like each other knowing but having no objection, like open relationship kind of a scenario is what it does indicates. The last pada of chesta. It is unfortunate for the longevity of the child. Generally, fathers suffer a lot after the birth of the child. Longevity of the child may not be good, and in young age, up to the age of 16, 17 years of age, the person will not have very good health. Right? The person is also religious, loves to visit holy places. Person is into reading, writing, authorship. The person is very intelligent, plans things well, right? And only does things after, like, you know, much contemplation. Is intelligent. Someone who is naturally aspired to intelligence. Someone who is naturally intelligent. Along with this, these things, he can be easily fooled also. And children, he will be like fortunate regarding children. We'll generally have male children only. Father will support. Mother, despite wanting to support, will not be in the position to support. Money settlement, luxuries, etc. comes late in life. The person is fair in complexion, beautiful. He is very restless. The biggest problem with Jyeshtha fourth pada is he cannot do anything for a long time. So if it is a short term affair, he is well to do. If it is a long time affair, he will not be able to do it, hold it, kind of a scenario. Will look calm outwardly, but inwardly will be, you know, very much disturbed. Will have tawny, beautiful, attractive eyes. He will have beautiful hair. Body will have a particular good kind of an odor. Right? Person generally wants to settle at a place, but circumstances will be otherwise, and he will have to forcibly move from places to places in order to continue with the living. A lot of travel which is not enjoyed by the native, but he have to do, is there in life. He will have a strong body, will have good relationship with elders, he will be skillful and trained in something, well trained in something. Along with this, the relationship with woman, be it any wife, mother, or any colleague, is not very good. Generally, the person is put under false allegations by females. And females, without any reason, may have enmity towards this person. For the one born in the Jyeshtha fourth pada. Right? So that's it for Jyeshtha. And as I told you, the results for Indra, we have covered Indra multiple times. I think the recent one in Chitra. So you can go through the Chitra class. Right? And as I have told before, it is a part of a course. Told it in the starting, right? And other classes will be exclusively to this student. Thank you for joining. Namaskar.